Hello, everybody, and welcome to Endless Mode. I'm Captain Emoji.
And I'm Mysterious Gamer X.
And we're back with some more Kamiko. And our third protagonist, Uzume, who's like a little archer with a hoodie.
She's so cute.
She is.
Unfortunately, she's a grass type.
Oh, and we're in the fire type stage. Nothing but magmars and macargos and torpoles.
So, unlike the other characters, Uzume cannot attack while moving. Because
she cannot move and shoot. But she's got a great spread pattern on that arrow attack, though.
And she closes one eye to shoot.
Oh, that's cute! Looks like she's blinking. I like the tail of her hoodie wiggles when you're running around. It's very cute. It's little details like that are just very good. And then something I was noticing is Yamato had the little like deer antlers. Kind of looks like Uzume's hood has like ram or sheep horns.
Yeah, found you.
But anyway, doesn't have a hat or a hoodie, so I wonder if there's some aesthetic piece I missed in her. Might go back and check that out later.
Oh, teleporting cat of doom.
It does look like a cat. And it takes more than one hit just to be extra annoying. I've seen a ton of those little Oh! You cannot get out. This is where you are now. Oh my goodness. I'm impressed that it offstage exists, you know, like, your arrow took that guy out off camera.
Heck yeah.
I mean, it is modern hardware and modern programming and stuff.
Okay, so this is... okay, fine. Probably goes, heck.
Ooh. There's a lot going on there.
All right.
Might want to clear that out before you do that again.
Getting sick of your stuff, Sage.
Can we just start? And already its gimmicks begin to wear on you a bit.
It's just complicated and messy. Probably actually a really good game design. Just... Oh, fantastic, okay.
What was your power up?
I don't know. That's a different button entirely. Maybe, maybe Hinome does have a power up.
Oh!
Man, that would have been really handy to know about getting to this stage.
Mysterious Gamer X had to play through, the previous stage with Uzume to get to this point. As his second playthrough, essentially. And the fact that Uzume has to stop and aim was a bit of a challenge with that high mobility boss. Well, at least you didn't fall into the lava.
Yikes, that is a fast timer.
Fast timer and fast respawn rate on those little jerks. No, that is a quick respawn time.
And leaving one of them alive.
Oh, so they don't respawn?
Exactly.
Clever. Okay.
Here we go.
Tactics. At the buzzer there. Nice job.
Probably don't want to fall into the lava.
And you'll want to grab whatever that is first, probably.
Health!
Oh, health is always good. You almost have a full health bar.
Heck yeah.
I guess it helps that you found the ones on the last stage with Yamato, so that we knew where they were next.
It's just better. Huh, that cat has a minimum range on those.
Barely, yeah. How do we get to that shrine on the right, though?
That's...
Like, I keep seeing it, because it keeps dangling in front of us. Oh!
Oh, Lord!
There's a lot going on there. Those little flame guys are real adamant about going and giving you a big hug. That was cool. There's two of those teleporting cats. I was wondering why it seemed like there was so much going on.
Yeah. That was kind of harsh.
A little bit.
And that'll happen every time I walk through that room.
That's probably important to note. Yeah. There's a maximum range on those too. Those little leaves that pop out of them.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it does do something. That goofy-looking little gyroid fella. He shoots fireballs. Because of course he does.
Okay, I've managed to grab a key and a door.
With no idea where they go, and just sort of a...
And I'm not going up that way, because they blocked the route. Can't fight with one of these.
You might have to clear it out and come back. Or, you might have to open this door here with that button, and it might be down there. I, for the life of me,
a single shrine.
It's true. But you've covered a lot of map and gotten a lot done. So it's not all for naught.
Yep, there's the door.
Oh, yep. I will admit that you've done a lot better job clearing these out quickly than me. I usually didn't bother grabbing anything after the first time I got stuck behind the door. So I think I did, like, twice as much doubling back as you. Because I would, you know, find the thing and then go back to the stuff. Oh, that looks like quite the goblin up there.
Yeah, no, that's going to be great.
Well, at least you have a lot of... You have range on everything. At least that's nice.
Yeah. Press around.
Having to chase those teleporting cats around Yamato and stuff.
I can imagine.
Just, you know, how it bounce around. It was a chore.
Alrighty. They do have to hit you dead on, too, so.
Yeah. Well, we found that shrine we kept seeing in the background.
Good! Shrine number one. Taken care of. Board four.
And then wherever that was. Yeah, because we haven't found the teleport pad that they all go to at the end.
Hey, look, it's the start of the level.
Oh! Wow, that was.
I wonder what's down.
That was a fair bit of doubling back, actually.
Just one giant circle.
Interesting game design, honestly. It didn't feel like a big circle. Ugh, sweet hell. Never they take a break back. There's that first teleport in there.
Oh yeah, that doesn't actually get me.
Gives you a nice shooting platform to take care of those guys, I guess. That room never ceases to surprise me.
Gets you every time, huh?
I mean, the door coming up isn't a big deal. It's just the volume of enemies in that room is just sort of ridiculous. Those little guys really look it when they get close to it.
Yeah, they do. that's that.
Right.
That's a switch. Somewhere.
Button somewhere. I'm surprised at how many little shrubs there are, considering this place is, like, on fire.
Yeah.
Not a complaint, just sort of a random observation.
Chest.
So, you gotta find another chest here.
Oh, yeah. And a lot more ass.
Oh, yeah. That kind of doesn't work. Then you have to fight them.
I don't know if those teleporting cats do much.
Oh?
It didn't seem to dig it. Oh, yeah.
How much other stuff is doing damage to you in this place?
Yeah, so that was the key.
I guess there's up there and then that crazy looking gun. Oh! There's the center of the stage. The shrubs.
Yeah. There's the gauntlets got. There's a shrine back there.
That is no fun time.
The important thing is we made it through.
You did. So what happens when you stand on the shrine?
It's a save point. But they save automatically. You get them, so...
I guess if you'd unlocked something and happened to come by, you could save.
Yeah.
I wonder if you just charge through there at the right moment.
Nope. Nope. That is definitely not a thing that happens.
Is that a map? The big tile that's stuck in the ground there?
Like could the lines
on it? I wonder if it's supposed to tell you where you are. I mean, it doesn't really have a whole lot of context, so I don't know if it's the most useful map. Just a thought.
I'm just gonna break these blocks to see if something useful can happen. It looks like I can push one of those.
Nope.
I see. Okay.
Oh. I think this is one of those
slide
puzzles. Sliding puzzles, yeah.
Click.
Say as long as it counts you as the other button, yeah, you're good.
And try number three. I haven't found any secret rooms, really. I grabbed that health.
So see, you got an extra health, so...
So there should be an energy around here somewhere.
Right.
Okay, so cats do damage, but they got a straight on.
Okay. It's just a very forgiving hitbox, then.
Yeah.
Well, that's good. Given how much is going on, I appreciate that. Oh!
There's that.
That'll make the return trip a little better than I thought it was. I thought you were going to go all the way around.
No, that would be unreasonable.
I mean, some games are unreasonable.
That's fair. What the bad guys are. Well, archers usually are.
I was gonna say, if we're following like tropes, I'm probably not that far off.
People who use hoodies
and people.
Yeah. Engage with people at their own range.
Engage with people at their own range, yeah. Don't let people get too close.
Alright, well, that'll be the end of the level. Did I grab the energy? Was there an energy?
I don't remember you grabbing an energy. Somewhere, but...
You know, I'm not gonna worry about it too hard. Oh no. Gonna try to find that thing without going through there again.
Oh.
I gotta go through one of them. Alright.
You have to make four of those gauntlet rooms. In order to get to the exit. That's pretty good.
Rather lose right. Energy than health.
True. The energy makes more of a difference now that you know what she has, especially.
Yeah, well.
I was surprised that they'd only given a special to one of them. It seemed unbalanced and unfair.
And here we go! What do you got for me this time, puzzle boss?
Well, I mean, you're at half health. I think you got this.
Oh, sure. Piece of cake. Hey, cat. I see the difficulty edition has come up. So thanks for that. This game was getting a tad too easy.
Yeah, you realized it was time to make your appearance in order to make it a true test.
If the meows don't make it through editing, cat has decided to...
You know, he's surprisingly quiet on my
Uh-oh. Okay.
I have on occasion during editing tried to amplify him enough that he'll show up on mic, but the ambient background noise of the room tends to get pretty deafening. So.
Oh, no.
Everyone just has to believe us when we say we have a cat. And given that he likes to rub himself on microphones and tackle pieces of equipment, I hope they don't just think I'm clumsy.
Oh, this is a good show.
I think I've posted a picture of him on Instagram right now. So, for those who follow us on Instagram, he is the Fluffy Kid, the big Fluffy Kid. Doesn't seem to have any interest whatsoever in what we're doing right now, so he doesn't interact as much with me.
Okay, so I think I've got this boss figured out.
But the boss may have figured you out first.
Yeah, oh, basically.
Ooh, the yeah, Delta all right. Formation.
Alright, I see how this is.
But I mean, you're going at it with full health now instead of half health. You know what his gimmick is, so this will be much better. He gets cooler enemies. Those little flame guys are much more useful than the slime guys.
Yeah, thanks for letting those just hang out.
Yeah. It's like an evil spiral. So it's got the one fixed point that it sort of draws around the stage.
Yeah. Blocking my shots.
Yeah, no, it seems like carrying on some flame guys.
Oh, that's how you activate the,
Oh, is that how you get him to stop?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, so that's super important. Okay. I was just thinking about the fact that they're really annoying.
Nope, that's the mechanic.
Uh-huh.
Take out all the little dudes while avoiding some very annoying.
You're doing good though.
Oh, I don't like this at all.
No, this is real bad. This is shooting now, too. He's done that before. have a special? I don't know. I was just looking for those hard to reach ones off the corners.
I think I got them. Please say I got them. Okay. All right. Yeah. So they take the classic retro three hits.
Yep.
All right. Wow.
Another job well done.
On to the fourth stage.
I believe stage four is the last one.
Yeah. The ruins of Yamatai. God, didn't read it.
I missed it.
Yamataiguchi. I don't know, something. Anyway. Next time on Endless Mode, we're going to figure out which character we want to finish the game with. Maybe you can help us out with that.
Yeah, like and subscribe. Tell us in the comments which of the characters you think we should
finish the
final boss
with. Maybe we even set up a Twitter poll. Who knows?
I'll try and figure that out. I can probably do that. Alright, thanks for watching. Take care.